Good afternoon, everybody. I am Vikas Arya, representing Jackson Group. Jackson is one of the integrated solar company in India, which are mainly, you know, started their journey in solar 8-9 years back with the, as a IPP developer. So we first, you know, started our 20 megawatt plant in BAP in Rajasthan under Jawaharlal Nehru Mission 1 project. And subsequently, we entered into EPC, and therefore later we had entered into manufacturing of modules and structures. So keeping in view, you know, all the sides of the major solar implications, like right from the developer to the EPC to the manufacturer. So we have gone through all the phases, and I can tell you the challenges are there in all the three fronts. There is not a single front where I can say, yes, this is something which is better. So it is very, very challenging. The positive side of it is that solar, you know, maybe 8 years back, the prices have dropped by more than 50%. So it has become more affordable, more solar plants we are seeing, everybody is going for solar. Today, even a small house, you know, which may not be very interested 3-4 years back, today they are also talking about solar. So that is a good sign about it. And the kind of, you know, installations that have happened in the last 3-4 years has given a lot of, you know, impetus to our energy mission and solar mission, and with the global companies entering into India. So that is a very much, you know, encouraging sign. But the flip side, as madam, you know, very, very rightly and, you know, tactfully addressed most of the concerns which are there. So which is also, you know, has to be addressed in line with that. So if the power you know, cost of solar power has come down from 90 rupees to less than 40 rupees today, so that is thanks, you know, to various things which helped in doing it. It is not that one, whether it is a Chinese makes, because many people say, you know, China is becoming, you know, is affecting Indian domestic market. But as a manufacturer, I tell, you know, China has given us that opportunity, or maybe given us that freedom, you know, to reduce the cost of the solar energy. So that is a plus side of it. And how we can, as a manufacturer, compete with China? Why my price cannot be lower than China if we are maintaining the same quality? So that is what we need to challenge ourselves and see that why we should follow China. We should be more innovative. We are much more innovative people in the country, and we can address that. But there, you know, something from the government definitely has to come into picture. Government policies, government support, with the addressing of safeguard duty last year, you know, in fact of prices of modules going up, the price of modules went down. So because even after safeguard duty also, I think it was being played by the Chinese manufacturers. They were dominating, you know, how the prices have to be made in India. So these are all few challenges which are there, but I am very hopeful, you know, that all these things will be settled. Now coming to 2-3 points, you know, what my colleagues were here addressing. First was, you know, the MMS. Now we are into MMS, you know, designing. The structure, rightly said, you know, there were certain projects which we did 4 years back. The structure weight was, you know, I would say more than 50 tons per megawatt. And today, you know, it has come down to almost 25 to 28 tons on an average. So there are 2-3 things which has gone through. One is the safety margin, which used to have been, you know, earlier were there, might have been reduced. And now we are making it more optimum, so that, you know, it is able to sustain whatever wind velocity, whatever, you know, things we are able to sustain, and with the also in the better increase in the availability of material. The MP of the, you know, material which is available, that has also improved over a period of time. So yes, the structure has, weight has come down, but at the same time, many times, you know, we are compromising on the final finishing of the product, or maybe the design of the product. Certain things we might be ignoring while doing the STAT analysis. So those things need to be taken care of at the design stage itself, because once the design is done and then you only leave it to the commercial, then definitely, you know, everybody will look for the lowest weight option only. So design plays a very important role here. So when we talk to our design and commercial team, we always tell them that design team has to first certify that this product or this design is meeting the technical requirement of the system. Then only you should go to commercial and purchase for purchasing. Because till that time, you know, then you always, you know, try to compromise on the quality. That is something which has to be, you know, looked into. And on the GST front, you know, I attended one of the meeting with the GST Council around 10 days back, where this particular point of GST was taken up with them along with the CII representatives. So we have made a representation to the GST Council regarding this GST, you know, implications, which may not be, you know, the right criteria of dividing it into 70 and 30. So the GST Council has requested, you know, you put up your representation through the industry. Let us see what we can do on it. So definitely the 70-30 ratio is not in the positive side, keeping in line the solar, for the growth of the solar. So we need to take it up as collectively as an industry, not individually, because it is affecting everybody, right from developer to EPC and to the end customer. So everybody is getting an impact of that extra liability of GST. So I think that need to be taken up with the government properly, strongly and firmly, and they have to understand what exactly we are talking about. Land-based project and the rooftop on the tin shed cannot have the same implication of the 30%. So there's a lot of difference. I tried to explain them, but just we have to put it in properly with the calculations, with the case studies. And then, you know, definitely maybe after elections, this issue might be taken up at the ministry level, and then we can take it up. But then time will only tell, you know, whether they take it positively or what decision they come up with. And then on the other side, the challenges what we are facing today, land-based, you know, is definitely, you know, land prices have gone up, and the most of the lands which are available today, you know, are in the remote areas where you don't have the good connectivity, the substations are not available, the infrastructure is not there. So these challenges, you know, where the government has to play a role to provide that infrastructure facility like solar parks. And so it is a mix of both. Today, when we talk about 100 gigawatt, you know, 40 gigawatt on rooftop and 60 gigawatt on the land-based, so that mix, you know, actually if you are able to implement it, it will definitely help everybody, because a lot of rooftop space is available which can be utilized, you know, properly. And with the decentralized systems, you can reduce the transmission losses, because most of the customers will be generating power and using power at the same place. So definitely it helps in reducing the generation transmission cost losses. At the same time, going for the land-based power pools, that is also important for the stability of the grid. Because each state has got their own land banks which are in the remote areas. If you are able to utilize that land banks properly and connect those big power plants, solar parks to the grid, in the national grid, so it can help us, you know, in the transmission of the surplus and shortfall, and surplus can be handled effectively. So I think a lot of discussions are going in the ministry also, how to make it effective. But yes, still presently there is a challenge. There are many areas which are surplus of power, many states still which are shortage of power. To bridge that gap and see that the extra power which is being generated by solar during the daytime, the, you know, on opening on this switching off and switching on of thermal power plants, so all these challenges are definitely there, which needs to be, you know, stressed so that all thermal plants also run smoothly in the most optimum way, solar plant energy is also used properly. I think the next big change, that storage energy, that policy is likely to be out shortly. So that is something which definitely will help, you know, in addressing many of the challenges of extra surplus power that we have, and we are able to do it. Now on the procurement side, what Abhishek ji says, I think Abhishek ji is the expert on the procurement. So I may not be the expert on the procurement side, but definitely, you know, I am in Jackson for the last 4 years, where I have handled, you know, a variety of, you know, roles and responsibilities. That includes, you know, developing of new products, interacting with the suppliers, meeting with the design teams, discussing plants. So I have a fair bit of idea, you know, what all things go when you go on the procurement side. As a purchase guy, normally he goes with the L1. So that is the first criteria of the purchase person. So many times he ignores on the quality, on the technical parameters. And for which, as Madam rightly said, we have to pay a big price. May not be immediately, may not be after 6 months, after 1 year, after 2 years. Because certain places where we have done this land-based projects, we have to replace modules. So that is a big, big cost. Because the generation or the commitments which were made by the module suppliers at that point of time were not met. And then they don't have anything, you know, we talk about Chinese module suppliers, but most of the Chinese module suppliers are good, but there are many who are not honoring their commitments. But as Jackson, we have our commitment to our customer. We cannot say no to the customer, sir, my module supplier is not, you know, supporting me, so I cannot support. Nothing doing on that. So we have to replace those modules from our end. So we have to pay a heavy price. And when we started, you know, understanding what has happened, it was some, you know, maybe hindsight, somebody, you know, only looked for the price at the time when the order was being decided. It overlooked certain things, which actually end up, you know, we have a huge challenges after that. So I think, as Madam rightly said, you know, I agree with her that we should have everything right from the design stage. If your design is perfect, your other things are correct, and then you start, you know, having the right selection of product, and then doing the installation properly, doing O&M. I think solar is one of the most easiest generation of power, because it is not having any rotating machine, unlike thermal or wind power. So it is the most easy, most simple. That is why everybody say this plant can run for 25 years, because there is nothing that it has to lose. There is no wear and tear. Inverter is only one product, you know, where you can say, okay, after some time you may have to change the cards. But with companies like SMA offering 25 years warranty, modules by default comes with 25 years warranty. There is nothing else, you know, you can look forward to. The most stable industry, most stable source of energy today, I think, is solar. And if you are able to do it properly, we do it effectively in the most optimum way, there is no reason, you know, why this industry should not grow, and why everybody, you know, linked with the industry should not prosper. But presently, yes, we are in those challenges of sustainability on the margins. It's a big, big challenge, but I think it will settle it down, you know, because many small players or many companies who are not very serious about solar are definitely, you know, are looking, having a relook whether they should continue with it or not. And the companies who are very serious into solar are going ahead with it, knowing very fully well, yes, today or tomorrow, definitely things will become better and everybody will understand what is the, you know, impact of doing the right thing. The companies who are doing right thing are definitely going to grow. So you have to maintain that systems, you know, properly. I think that's all from my side. Thank you.
Thanks, Vikasji. Vikasji pointed out a very important point while going with L1 vendor. So I believe now the first procurement strategy should be how you list your vendors. You should send, before sending any inquiry, you should check your basic parameters. Government is also doing that. They have defined BIS standards. They are bringing in lot of standards so that everyone knows. Even I saw a circular from MNRE, they asked to follow BIS certifications and not go by any other listing or any other thing. So first thing you should understand before procurement, you should, as Madam also mentioned, top notch, the word she used. So before procuring anything, you should check the track record in India. If a product is new, you should take it as a pilot level. If a product is having a track record in India, you are safe. So it should have a proven track record. Second thing, how is the company, whether it is sustainable or not, whether it will be able to honor their warranties or not. So if these two things you are able to find out, you are in safe hands. Then last is the price and L1 and payment terms backed by BGs and all commercials, taxation, shipment, freight, FOR site, CIF. So all these things comes last. But before procuring, you should have your vendor evaluation done right. If you're doing your right vendor evaluation with the help of engineering team, with your technical team, with your quality team, there are very, you are mitigating your project risks. And technology which you are selecting is also proven, then also you are mitigating your construction risk, because solar normally utility scale is for 25 years. You should build a good plant. Now I would request Mr. Abhijit to give his insights on the topics covered.
This side, Abhijit Singh from Bosch Limited. So I got the chance in the end. So I almost all the like topics which they have, which with design, procurement, other things I had specified. But apart from these, I would like to specify one thing, that is safety. So installing a solar plant, getting the generation out, that is an integral part, and that what customer expects, it would be a government customer or a private customer or a CAPEX customer. On the safety side, with respect to, I would say, first of all, sheet roofs. Initially, when we started around 8 years back, 9 years back, we have seen solar plants being installed on the shed. Directly, like it was like we have, it looks that we have pasted the modules on the sheet roof. Then gradually people has realized that now sheet roof is being damaged, and now if a shed angle is more than 3 degrees, 4 degrees, it is 15 degrees, then a person can fall also. So after this, that in the design aspect, handrails and walkways are being introduced. So when these were introduced, now handrail height should be how much, then it is producing shadow. Now what is the strength, and now what should be the mechanism through which we will install the handrails on the peripheral as well as the walkways. And now there are more engineering being done on the quality of material that need to be installed, because if we use a checker plate or we use a, generally we have seen like the walkways are of checker plate and other material. So now if we have seen the introduction of FRP also. So where the life is more than 15 years, breakage is very less. If the gradient of FRP is being used and the combination of glass with a higher, higher integration, higher level of glass we have used, glass plates we have used, then the breakage is very less. So by using all these things, the safety is higher, safety is being covered, but now on the aspect of cost. So I would say generally on a rooftop, BOS, if we say we exclude the safety part, the BOS comes out to be 7 rupees per watt peak or 6 rupees per watt peak. But when we introduce such handrails and safeties and lifeline, it increase the cost of 2.5 rupees. So I would say in market, we need to educate this to the customer, and as a company, every EPC company should have a commitment of doing this, because generating power, facilitating to the customer, getting your revenues is one. Secondly, the safety of the customer as well as the resource which is working on it is the second part, which is very important. Then on the side of design, I would say design, when we started, I started around 9 years back doing solar. We were, when we started off doing sheet roof, initially it would be a very small quantity of 50, 60, 100 kilowatt, 200. And now we are at a stage where we have installed 5 megawatt single rooftop at Honda. So there we have seen designing is something which is very, we can say it's a common sense, where how you can install modules and you can install in such a way where you can clean it properly. You are putting a walkway from there, modules are in the range of 5 meters or 6 meters or 10 meters, then cleaning will be a task. And then later or sooner, you are doing the O&M, that is the best part, where you train your people and you know that they don't walk. But I have seen where we have installed on capex basis to the customer, and plant capacity is also 3 megawatt. Where customer is doing its own O&M and people are literally walking on the modules and cleaning it. So these are the things where customer itself don't realize, because as a owner, he don't have time to go on the roof and see. But on the later stage, I would say after 10 years, 9 years, there will be huge micro cracks, and which will lead to the loss to the customer itself. So these things of O&M, O&M related to design part is one. Which companies has to take care, and which we should educate to the customer also, so that he understand that if we are using a walkway, multiple walkways, that is good for him, the customer only. It's not that cost is increasing, but this will give him a convenience as well as the plant and modules will be safe. And lastly, on the part of procurement. So I see presently we used to go outside, customer used to ask that we need German modules, we need imported modules. So presently I would say India has worked brilliantly on the module and inverter part, where it is specified that there are these modules, these makes are available, and they are at par in India, and customer is also satisfied. Now the unregularized part which I see is BOS. Where from structure, I would say cables, then I told safety part, handrail, walkways. So these are the part where still more regularization needs to be done. And I see there is everyone know like how market is going on the margins with respect to modules and inverters. But now BOS part need to be regularized. Where margin everyone has to earn, that is fine, but where we need to regularize so that the cost of the overall project comes down, because presently also we see customer are not that friendly. I would say if I talk about capex customers, they are not that friendly with installing a solar power plant, because they say ki ROI is 4 years. If you include bank cost, then it's a different scenario. Then customers say no, we don't want to install solar because the ROI is more than 5 years. And then the second part, we try to encourage and show a bright side that there is an AD also. But you see majorly customers don't see AD. AD is just a bookish figure which it doesn't lucrate the customer. So if we go now presently rooftop, good solar plant, more than 500 kilowatt comes in a range of 37,000 to 38,000 per kilowatt. If more optimization being done in terms of product, solar plant, we do optimization, then we can reach it to somewhere around 30 to 33 with the all important amenities need to be taken care, then it will be more lucrative for the customers, capex customers, to go forward.
Thanks, Mr. Abhijit, on covering the safety aspects and other rooftop features. Now, I would request Mr. Animesh to give his insights on the topics we have covered.
Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. Actually, I'm representing Godrej over here, and we are into EPC, core. We are doing core EPC. We ventured in 2011 and did first installation of 20 kilowatt. But today we are doing multi-megawatt project throughout Pan-India basis, on Pan-India basis. The biggest challenge what Godrej or what other EPC companies are facing in rooftop is the price. The price market, which is driven by the local companies who are venturing day by day. To be very frank, I'm facing this problem a lot. And the companies which are, because solar is having a lot of potential, you know, we have a lot of potential in the market, and everybody wants to get the chunk of the piece and then do a profitable business. But getting the order is the biggest challenge. Everybody is coming and giving such a price that which we as an EPC, as a quality EPC who focus on quality and after service and then safety, we cannot match their prices. So the biggest challenge what we are facing currently in the market is the price market which is going on. And I would like to just say this much for the EPC part.
Now I would move to the third topic, use of trackers, drones, IoT, and advanced analytics in project execution and operation. Since I started working for solar procurement, tracker is always a discussion point, whether to use a tracker or not to use. The main points which I feel we should consider while designing your plant or whether considering tracker or not. One is your tracker is, there is an increased cost, but there is an increased generation also. So, and there is an increased cost. So your land will reduce down, may reduce down your BOS, DC BOS may reduce down if you use tracker, and your generation will increase. But another critical factor is module price. Means if you are reducing your DC BOS by using tracker, and your vis-a-vis you are putting extra modules, how your model behaves and how your PV system analysis behaves. So if you are able to analyze these aspects and reach a conclusion, then you can decide whether to use a tracker or not. In tracker, one of the main features is it's a moving, and you will need a prolonged warranty. You would, as a developer, I would always ask for a prolonged warranty for 25 years because I have to run plant for 25 years. And another point is, if you are using a tracker, is there any obsolescence risk if your tracker is driven by actuator? Is that actuator available, will be available till 25 years? So these are all aspects which I feel is always a point of discussion while designing any solar plant. So we have Dheeraj with us, I believe he will put some insight on this.
With respect to tracker, I would say this is an interesting technology, worldwide deployed. So no problems with respect to the experience of the technology, with respect to the deployment of the technology, with respect to the workmanship involved, with respect to the construction, with respect to the execution of the entire stuff. So that is well available, deployed, humongous experience within India, outside India, with respect to trackers. So initially there was interconnected trackers using a shaft, then there comes the independent row trackers having their own actuators and other stuff, motors. Then there are several changes happening within the tracker itself. Like earlier there were tracker which on a 60 meter wider stuff are carrying 60 modules only. So one module rather than 2P module or 4L module. But now trackers are also getting changed in their technology that they can carry more number of modules in the limited space, and therefore again increasing the generation more than the capex. The usability of tracker, yes or no, is again also dependent on module. If you see the module price particularly, when the module prices were high, then uses of tracker is enabling more generation vis-a-vis less capex infusion. But if the module prices, which are presently also, if we take those prices into consideration, you will find that putting up more number of modules with that particular extra capex may be making more sense than using the trackers. Because if you see tracker as a standalone is something where the structure is actually giving you a generation, if you see in the nutshell. The tracker is something where structure is giving you the generation instead of the module. So you have to compare it directly with respect to the module price. If you find that the module prices are higher, then yes, tracker may make sense. If you find module prices are lower, you have more land space available with you, then maybe a fixed tilt or a seasonal tilt technology makes sense for you. Tracker has something which has to do with the latitude also. If you go into the down south, like the areas of Karnataka, Andhra or Tamil Nadu, tracker gain is much, much higher than what you can gain in the northern region of India, like Rajasthan, Haryana or Punjab. Because here the latitude is more, and therefore single axis tracker gain is to the tune of, you can say, 16% to 18%. But if you go down south, this same gain increases to 22% to 22%, subjected to, yes, grid availability, your sunshine, your removing the rainy season and other aspects. But technically, yes, it has a 3% to 4% or 5% extra gain between north and down south. With respect to IoT or other aspects, that is, I think, the need of the hour, because single developer is carrying so many different projects in their kitty, using different technologies and giving very different kind of generation. So as a developer, as a portfolio owner, I need to know how my plant is performing, how my neighbor's plant is performing in the same vicinity using the same technology, and how they are performing using the different technology. Because all those data and analysis will make us to improve my position for the future, that if I have to put up another project, which technology I should use, which module, which inverter, which type of integration, what kind of block size I have to use, all those aspects I can only get to know if I have the data of my current projects and the neighborhood of my current projects, how they are performing with respect to radiations, with respect to my expectations, the numbers I have put up in my financial model, whether they are generating up to the mark, more than that or less than that, how the operations and maintenance are performing. Because if your neighborhood plant is performing much better in the same radiation area and using the same technology, then definitely there is something wrong with the operations and maintenance. And therefore, you have to then boil down to the operations and maintenance techniques and other aspects. So IoT data analytics is gonna play a very, very big role for a portfolio kind of projects by a single developer, to screenshot each and every plant on his screen in a very informative manner, rather than too much data clubbing at a single location.